New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has officially introduced her newborn daughter to the world. Ms. Ardern, 37, and her partner Clark Gayford introduced baby Neve Tiaroha Ardern Gayford to the media after her birth on Thursday afternoon. Ardern's choice of name, Neve, which is traditionally spelt as Niamh, has Irish roots, meaning bright and radiant. She has since thanked hospital staff for her care and already noted the sleep deprivation has kicked in. Ms. Ardern was the first world leader to have a baby in office in 30 years and only the second ever. Ms. Ardern, 37, and her partner Clark Gayford announced the birth of their first child, weighing 7 pounds 3 ounces, on Instagram. She follows in the footsteps of the late Pakistan Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto, who in 1990 became the only democratically elected female world leader in recorded history to give birth while in power. "Welcome to our village, we won," Ms. Ardern wrote on Instagram alongside a picture of her and Mr. Gayford with their new arrival. "Feeling very lucky to have a healthy baby girl that arrived at 4:45 p.m. weighing 3.31 kilograms, 7.3 pounds. Thank you so much for your best wishes and your kindness. We're all doing really well thanks to the wonderful team at Auckland City Hospital." Scroll down for videos. Ms. Ardern's office said mother and child are doing well. "I'm sure we're going through all of the emotions new parents go through, but at the same time feeling so grateful for all the kindness and best wishes from so many people," Ms. Ardern said in a statement. Her office said it would announce later when the family leave the hospital, who are expected to speak to a crowd of reporters who have been camped outside the hospital since Ms. Ardern arrived there early Thursday morning. Ms. Ardern was due on June 17. Share this article. Share the 37-year-old worked right up until she went into labor on Thursday morning. The New Zealand government will be led by Winston Peters, 73, for the next 6 weeks. Ms. Ardern assured she would still be on call and the government would be business as usual. For more than a month, Ms. Ardern has talked down the significance of her leave, saying she'll still be receiving briefings and be available for major decisions or to discipline ministers if necessary. "The thing to keep in mind is, I'm not dead," she told TVNZ.but. While Ms. Ardern has been working to assure the nation, Mr. Peters has been causing a stir. He lodged a privacy breach lawsuit against a government department the day Ms. Ardern left Wellington, recently scuttled the major piece of labor policy, and has attacked the leadership of the country's largest company. During Ms. Ardern's maternity leave, Mr. Peters, the leader of the minority New Zealand First Party, which forms part of New Zealand's coalition government, will have powers similar to those he would have if the Prime Minister was overseas. He will run the day-to-day operations in Wellington and will consult with Ms. Ardern on significant political, strategic, or public interest or national security matters. But he'll still be limited by the decisions of the Labour Party-dominated cabinet. Recent NewsHub Read research polling found 39% think Mr. Peters will do a good job, the rest were either unsure or pessimistic. Often described as a populist, Mr. Peters is the most experienced hand and one of the most iconic figures in the country's political landscape, but he is also polarizing and has an often combative relationship with the media. He's formed coalition governments with both the center-left and center-right, playing the role of kingmaker to leverage concessions out of the major parties, and since entering parliament in 1979 has held numerous senior cabinet posts, including deputy PM in the 1990s. But while he and Ms. Ardern's Labour Party may not have seen eye to eye on some issues recently, they've been talking up the trust between them. "I've almost found it surprising people have questioned that it will be anything other than business as usual for us," Ms. Ardern said. She became a mother just months after she took the country's top job in October. Ms. Ardern announced she was pregnant in a Facebook post in January this year. "I'll be Prime Minister and Imam, and Clark will be first man of fishing and stay-at-home dad," she said at the time. "I think it's fair to say that this will be a wee one that a village will raise, but we couldn't be more excited."